All right, welcome to Multiplying Integers. So before we get started, let's go ahead and remember that we want to watch the whole video all the way through and then come back and take notes. We really want you to listen so that you can pay attention and understand before you go through and write everything down. Okay, so today with multiplying integers, we're talking about same signs, and we want to always remember that the product of two integers with the same sign is always positive. So let's look at an example. 3 times 7. Well, we know this one already, right? 3 times 7, we should remember that it's 21. And then we also want to do -3 times -7. Okay, well, are they the same sign? They are. So we know that the product of two integers with the same sign is always positive. So this is also going to be positive 21. Now, if they have different signs, the product of two integers with different signs is always negative. So paying attention to the difference here, we've got our negative and our positive, right? Same signs are positive, different signs are negative. So, first example for different signs, we've got 4 and -2. Well, 4 times 2 is 8. It's just regular multiplication. And now, since they have different signs, they're going to have a negative answer. So it's -8. And it doesn't matter which way it's written, which one is negative and which one is positive. It's always going to be a 4 times 2, which is 8. And since one's negative and one is positive, it's going to be a -8.
Yep. And you can also remember too that if it was just +8, then they would either both have to be positive or both have to be negative. So you're like, okay, well, it's 8, but then one of it is negative. So you just have to, again, remember those little ways to help you with multiplying. So last year, one of the things that we came up with was what I called the sleeping MD integer man. And the MD, you can think about it for. You can only use the sleeping integer man for multiplication and division. And then I also, if you know, the MD stands for a doctor, a medical doctor. So let's go ahead and draw his head. And I, again, once I get the software or the hardware for writing on the screen, it'll be a lot easier. So that's his head. And here's his eyes because he's sleeping. He's super tired. And that's his mouth. So then I like to draw the bow tie. And it would have the M and the D. And remember, he's a doctor. I don't really like that bow tie. I'm gonna erase that one. So he's a doctor, so he's super tired and he's sleeping. And the MD reminds us that we can only use it for multiplication and division. It's a little bit bigger, but it works. Anywho, okay, so here's how it goes. And let me get the highlighter. So I have -6 times -3. So I have the giggles. They're both negatives. So I'm going to go ahead and cover both of these up. What I'm left with is a positive. So -6.
Times -3 is going to be a positive because both of the negatives are highlighted. So the one that's not covered is a positive number. So 6 times 3 is 18. And it's a positive 18.
Yeah. Okay, and let me go ahead and I'll just erase the highlight. Thanks, Ms. Peterson, for helping me out. Okay, and then the next one, again, you have one negative and one positive. Mrs. DiBartolo has the giggles. Here we go. So -4, so that's going to be one negative and then one positive. So we know that 4 times 8 is 32. So I'm going to go ahead and write 32. And then I need to look at my sleeping integer man to help me find out if it's going to be a negative or a positive. So a -4, I'm going to cover up the negative, and then a +8. So I'm going to cover this up. What is uncovered or what's left over is going to be your sign. So you can see that that's going to be negative 32. And then the last problem is a little bit more challenging, but we can still use our sleeping integer man to help us out. So the way I have this is -3 times 4 times negative 2. But I'm going to go ahead and just multiply two integers at a time. So negative 3 times 4, this is going to be a negative 12. Because it's different signs. Again, if I was to cover up the negative and a positive, I'd be left with a negative. So it's going to be negative 12. And then remember, when parentheses are smacked up against each other, it means multiplication. So now I'm back to just multiplying two numbers. We started with 3. I use these to make, multiply the first two to get negative 12. And then I multiply it by negative 2. So negative 12 times negative 2. So it's going to be the same sign. And if I can't use the rhyme for the adding integers. I have to use the sleeping integer man. And again, he's a doctor, the MD. He only works for multiplication and division. So same sign. I would cover up his eyes and I'd be left with a positive. So it's going to be a positive. And then 12 times 2 is 24. So it's positive 24. Here's another way you could do it, is just multiply straight across. 3 times 4 is 12. 12 times 2 is 24. And then go back through and look at your negatives. So negative times a positive gives me a negative. And then a negative times a negative gives me a positive. Whichever way works for you. Just go slow. Don't try to go too fast. So just like when we talked about for the adding integers, we have these properties for multiplication. So again, the key word is this identity. So I like your use of a highlighter, Ms. Peterson. So we have this identity, and thinking about, you want to keep yourself the same. You like you, and you should like you, and you don't want to be anybody else. So if I'm a negative 3, what can I multiply by myself to get a negative 3? So the only thing that works to keep my identity the same is a 1. And that's why we call it this multiplicative identity. It's kind of a mouthful there, but mathematicians like to have these fancy words. So basically it's just saying 1. What can I multiply by myself to keep myself the same is a 1. And then the other property that we have is property of 0. Again, some of these properties are kind of common sense, but we just want to show you this. So negative 4 times 0 is going to be 0. So the product of a number and 0 is always going to be 0. Just like if it was 5,281, it would be 0 if I'm multiplying by 0. Anything you want to add to that slide?
Just the big thing to look at is when they're doing these problems in a star test, they're going to have multiple choice. And looking at what operation is being done is going to be half of the battle when
Absolutely.
You're looking for
yeah.
it. So it says the multiplication property of 0
yeah.
or the identity property of multiplication.
Yeah.
That's an indicator there, is that multiplication.
Yeah, definitely. And especially like with the identity property of addition, you know you would look for an addition sign. So that's definitely a good point, Ms. Peterson.
So next up, we're going to talk about something that's always really confusing. Okay, so right here, we're not thinking it's too confusing yet. Let's go ahead and remember that negative 2 to the second power means negative 2 times negative 2. Right? We know how to do that. No big deal. Negative 2 times negative 2. Well, 2 times 2 is 4. And... oh.
That's okay. Sometimes it's I know. That's always giggling. So there you go.
Doop.
And once you have this drawn on your paper, you can just draw it and use your cover it up with your fingers.
I'm just doing it again because you can't see it right now on the screen. So we've got negative 2 times negative 2. Remember that we've got, and really, I really wanted to make sure that there's green and yellow on the page. So a negative times a negative leaves us with a positive. My answer is going to be a positive here. And which it is.
Yep.
Right. So looking at the next thing, this is really where people get confused. We've got negative 2 to the second power. Okay, well, this negative right here, it's not attached to the 2. Okay, it's the opposite of 2 squared. Well, 2 squared means 2 times 2. Well, what's 2 times 2? 4. Right? But it's the opposite. That's a bad arrow.
That would go back and erase
Sorry,
that.
guys. It is the opposite of 2 times 2. And so it's going to be the opposite of 4, which is, that's bad too. It's the opposite of 4, which is negative 4. I'm sorry.
No, it's okay.
I'm an amateur. Okay, so I know this is really confusing, but when it's in parentheses, a negative times a negative is a positive. When it's not in parentheses, you keep your answer as negative.
I like the way that you use that negative two as like saying that that's going to be the opposite of two squared. Okay.
So now we've got one that's a little more challenging. Remember, negative 3 to the fourth power is in parentheses. So it means negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3. Bet that was a surprise. So remember, negative 3 times negative 3, we've got 3 times 3 is 9. Negative times a negative gives us a positive. Now it's going to be 9 times negative 3. And I want to have more room here to get 9 times negative 3, which is 27. And again, we've got a negative and a positive, so our answer left is negative. We have negative 27 times negative 3. And I don't know about you, but I think I need to write it down this way.
I call that old school writing it down because I think sometimes we just want to try to do it in our head, but
Yeah.
I'm very visual, so I always end up having to write it down.
So I have 3 times 7 is 21. I'm going to carry my 2. 3 times 2 is 6, plus 2 is 8. So my answer is going to equal 81. And I'm going to go back and look, it's a negative and a negative. So my answer is going to be a positive. Okay. So next time we're going to talk about dividing integers. Okay. Make sure you write down any questions you have, and we'll answer them in class.
All right. See you guys.